Hey, Ando, I think I have something that falls under one of our favourite topics, a dad conspiracy.
Great.
And on 131060, I'm sure there'll be many more dad conspiracies out there. This is a category of idea that only dads have, and they're vehemently behind.
But your dad
them.
Is a rich treasure chest.
Dad, think of any conspiracy theory film. Dad is the guy with the graying beard sitting in the aluminium foil cage, worried the government's onto him about anything.
But in the films, normally that person turned out to be right.
Normally you'll have a Denzel Washington or something, or Keanu being the only one that believes in him, and his opinions will be vindicated.
We're yet to find someone who believes your dad.
And you won't get it from this one. Dad and I, a few weeks ago, went over to Dad's place and we're on the train together. Right? We're going into the city and, you know, on the train, there's often graffiti scratched into windows.
Yeah.
Right? Like people put their tags on windows and stuff.
It's appalling behaviour. Can we say it?
Despicable.
Appalling.
I mean, who are these youths, right? Dad goes, it baffles me. Right. He says to me, it baffles me that these women come on the train and they scratch these words in. I go, whoa, bit sexist. Why is it women? He goes, because they're doing it with their engagement rings.
Oh, God.
I said, what do you mean? He goes, mate, diamond cuts glass. That's why they do it. They're doing it. They get bored and they scratch it in with their engagement ring. And I said, it's not women, Dad. It's not women with it. It's not 24-year-olds with a $10,000 ring scratching tags into train windows. He goes, mate, diamond cuts glass. Rock beats scissors. I get it. But I think you're missing the point slightly here. It's like people with keys and stuff. I'm trying to tell him, without actually getting up and demonstrating to Dad, like, I'll do my tag, Dad, on the window with a key. It's not women with their engagement
rings. I've seen one that says, show us your tits. I don't think it was a woman who sat there with her engagement ring and went, this would be funny.
This would be hilarious.
Yeah.
Just a lot of business women with engagement rings on trains scratching tags in. Wouldn't believe me. Dad,
really?
I said, do you think girls, think about it, Dad. I mean, you've known some girls in your time. Do you think girls would risk popping out the diamond just so they could get the tag on the window? He goes, mate, that's why they get such a deep cut. And said, it's cheap glass. It's keys. Dad, convinced. It's engagement rings that are causing graffiti on trains.
131060, do you have a dad conspiracy to beat that one?
Honey, I want to spend the rest of my life with you. Will you marry me? Yes, and if you'll excuse me for a moment, I'm going straight down to the train to start tagging. I've wanted one of these rings forever.
Maxine on 131060, your dad has a conspiracy.
Yeah, he actually, when we're younger, like, we got, you know, those Furbies for Christmas?
Oh, you got a Furby, yep.
Yeah, well, he actually never let us, like, be in our room, like, turned on and stuff, because he used to think the government was, like, watching us and listening to us.
Oh, crazy dad. Oh, so he thought it was sort of like a bugging device.
Yeah, he thought the government, like, that's how they would track us, and they used to, like, watch us through their eyes and listen to us.
Yeah. Was there great need for the Australian government to track what you guys were up to?
Definitely not. I was like 10, so.
Yeah, I can imagine.
All jokes aside, though, that is what Teddy Ruskin does.
Thanks, Maxine. 131060, Mike, your dad has gotten something very wrong.
Yes, mate, this one's a classic. We were driving along down the road, and you know the pedestrian lights that have got the amber lights flashing on and off, on and off?
Yep.
He's just driven straight through him while someone's walking across. This lady with a pram walks across. He's just gone straight. And I said, Dad, what are you doing? He says, they're optional. I said, how do you come up with the optional? He says, there's no red, there's no green.
So he thinks it's not an amber, it's just an ambiguous. Just, whatever, I don't know. Whatever you guys want to do, sort it out. Don't mind me, I'm more just here for the disco. I have no meaning.
Thanks, Mike. Claire, your dad has a conspiracy as well.
He does. My dad thinks he got a phone call on his mobile the other day from his private health insurance to do a survey.
Yeah.
And he was convinced that they were trying to call him to waste his battery on his mobile phone, which in turn would cost him in electricity to recharge his battery.
Oh, so they're from the electricity company.
Yeah. So he would have to recharge his battery, which wastes his battery life of his mobile, and then in turn would cost him more in an electricity bill because he had to charge his battery.
Claire, did you say to him that them calling and making that call would cost them more?
That would forego the profits.
I said to him, you don't get charged for the phone call, but he was like, yeah, but it wastes my battery and that uses more electricity.
What an intricate plan. How many man hours, how much organisation goes into that? And the other thing is, they don't know where he is, so they're taking a punt that he'll recharge it at home. Could be this whole gamble for nothing.
It's a great one. Hamish and Andy.